In 1929, after refining his equipment and his skills, Dr. Hans Berger described the first two brain waves ever discovered, alpha and beta. He is best known as the inventor of the electroencephalography, EEG, a method for recording brain waves. Unfortunately, Berger's work ran counter to the brain theories then prevalent in the contemporary medicine, and his work was rejected by most of his colleagues. British and American scientists believed that what he was measuring was the result of an electrical artifact, and one even wrote that he was highly skeptical of the possibility of recording anything of significance from the surface of the brain. Berger was forced into retirement from his university professorship, and his health worsened. He sank into depression and he took his own life in 1941. He countered and challenged prevalent theories. They laughed at him and rejected him. Today we take EEG for granted, yet this type of ignorant and exclusive behavior still exists. The neurons in your brain fire together in rhythmic patterns, communicating with each other across the brain. These patterns are measured in cycles per second, or hertz. Imagine an audience clapping together slowly. That is a slow brainwave with millions of neurons firing together slowly. Now imagine an audience clapping quickly. That is a fast brainwave with millions of neurons firing together quickly. Today's EEGs calculate wave patterns from each of the brain's many different parts, and they typically use 19 electrodes attached to the surface of the skull. There are five basic brain waves that are picked up by a modern EEG. Gamma is the highest brain wave frequency, 40 to 100 hertz. It is most prevalent at times when the brain is learning, making associations between phenomena and integrating information from many different parts of the brain. A brain producing lots of gamma waves reflects complex neural organization and heightened awareness. When monks were asked to meditate on compassion, large flares of gamma were found in their brains. They were then compared to novice meditators who have only meditated for an hour a day a week before. The novices had brain activity similar to that of the monks. When the monks were instructed to evoke a feeling of compassion, their brains began to fire in rhythmic coherence, like the audience clapping all in sync, like one clap. Gamma is associated with very high levels of intellectual function, creativity, integration, peak states, state of flow, and of feeling in the zone. Gamma waves flow from the front to the back of the brain about 40 times per second. Measurements of brain waves show peaks and valleys. The distance from the peak to the throw is the amplitude. Amplitude is measured in microvolts, and brain waves typically measure between 10 and 100 microvolts, with the fast waves like gamma having the lowest amplitude. It is electricity. Gamma is associated with many beneficial changes in our body. A frequency of 75 hertz is epigenetic, triggering the genes that produce anti-inflammatory proteins in the body. On the lower end of gamma spectrum, 50 hertz results in the body increasing its production of stem cells, the blank cells that differentiate into muscle, bone, skin, or whatever other specialized cells are required. The frequency of 60 hertz regulates the expression of the stress genes, those that code for stress hormones like cortisol. The same frequency also activates a key gene called MYC, M-Y-C, that in turn regulates around 15% of all other genes in the body. beta is typically divided into two groups, high beta and low beta. High beta is your monkey mind. High beta, 15 to 40 hertz, is the signature brainwave of people with anxiety, people experiencing frustration, and people under stress. The more stressed people become, the higher the amplitude of the beta their brains produce. Negative emotions such as anger, fear, blame, guilt, and shame produce large flares of beta in the EEG readout. This shuts down the brain regions that involve rational thinking, decision making, memory, and objective evaluations. Blood flow to the prefrontal cortex, the thinking brain, is reduced by up to 80%. Starved of oxygen and nutrients, our brain's ability to think clearly plummets. Low beta is the band that synchronizes our body's automatic functions, so it is also called the sensory motor rhythm frequency, or SMR, 12 to 15 hertz. Beta is required for processing information and for linear thinking. For normal levels of beta are fine. When you focus on solving a problem, composing a poem, calculating the best route to your decision, or balancing your checkbook, beta is your friend. SMR represents a calm, focused mental state. It is the stress that produces high beta, especially above 25 hertz. High beta, the signature brainwave of a stressed out consciousness, actually suppresses DNA synthesis. Alpha, 8 to 12 hertz, is an optimal state of relaxed alertness. Alpha actually connects the higher frequency, the thinking mind of beta, the associative mind of gamma, with the two lowest frequency brainwaves, which are theta, 4 to 8 hertz, and delta, 0 to 4 hertz. Theta is characteristic of light sleep. When we dream vividly, our eyes move rapidly and our brains are primarily in theta. Theta is the frequency of rapid eye movement, REM sleep. Theta is also the dominant frequency of people under hypnosis, healers, people in trances, and people in highly creative states. The recollection of emotional experiences, both good and bad, can trigger theta. The slowest frequency is delta. Delta is characteristic of deep sleep. Very high amplitudes of delta are also found in people who are in touch with non-local mind, even when they are wide awake. The brains of meditators, intuitives, and healers have much more delta than normal. The eyes of people who are in deep dreamless sleep do not move. Delta waves are also predominant in such non-rapid eye movement and REM sleep. During sleep, when brains are primarily in theta and delta brainwave states, beta amyloid production in the brain ceases and toxic material is cleared away. EEG pioneer Maxwell Cade noticed that alpha in the middle of the range of frequencies forms a bridge between the two frequencies of beta and gamma and the two low frequencies of theta and delta. Biofeedback and neurofeedback skills focus on teaching people how to get into an alpha state. The ideal state is enough alpha to link all of the other brain rhythms together. High beta is minimized so that there's very little monkey mind and anxiety. There's a balanced amount of gamma and theta and a wide base of delta. As noted, alpha waves are right in the middle of the spectrum with beta and gamma above and theta and delta below. When someone in the awakened mind state has lots of alpha, it creates a link between a high frequencies above and the low frequencies below. Cade called this the alpha bridge because it bridges the conscious mind frequencies of beta with the subconscious and unconscious frequencies of theta and delta. This allows a flow of consciousness integrating all the levels of mind. Cade wrote, "The awakening of awareness is like gradually awakening from sleep and becoming more and more vividly aware of everyday reality. Only it's everyday reality from which we are awakening. Delta is where we connect with many resources above and beyond the local self. Those in a creative trance, such as a composer making music or a child at play, usually have lots of delta. They lose all awareness of the outer world as they become absorbed in their creativity. They're mostly in delta, with some theta and alpha, and just enough beta to function. People whose brains show a high amplitude of delta during meditation report transcendent experiences. They describe feelings of one with the universe, an exquisite sense of harmony and well-being. And Albert Einstein referred to this as an expansive state of consciousness in which we embrace all living creatures and the whole of nature. Normal brain function. All six frequencies are present with balance between left and right hemispheres. A person with anxiety has lots of high beta, little alpha, theta, or delta. The awakened mind pattern, large amounts of delta and theta, and lowered beta, plentiful alpha, provides an alpha bridge between the conscious mind beta and the unconscious and subconscious levels theta and delta. The energy fields of brainwaves and the matter of neural pathways are constantly an evolving dance. When consciousness changes, brainwaves change and different neural pathways are engaged. The extremes are love and fear. When we are in a state of fear, the alpha bridge disappears. We may still have theta and delta, but we are cut off from the resources of a subconscious mind and its connection with the universal whole. Beta waves flood the fearful brain and it is in survival mode. As our consciousness is filled with love, our brains function very differently. Large amounts of theta and delta, plus an alpha bridge to connect our conscious with the subconscious mind. Emotions create brain states. The feelings we feel are brainwave patterns hijacked by emotional contagion, and they're real. We have a spike in stress-related beta waves and drop in alpha. It takes a strong mind to remain unaffected by the mass hysteria around us. What are you doing to make your mind a strong one? The research on the performance gains produced by these brainwave states include 490% improvement in mental focus, a doubling of creativity, a 500% increase in productivity. These are linked to neural transmitters entering a state of bliss, anandamide, a sense of detachment from the body that encapsulates the local self, endorphins, local self bonding with the non-local universe, oxytocin, serenity, serotonin, and the reward of being changed by the experience, dopamine. These are the characteristics of upgraded minds. They are frequencies you can induce yourself. No medication, herbs, beliefs, or mind-altering substances required. Studies show that many spiritual practices change brainwaves. Mindfulness produces a host of beneficial changes in brainwaves. Research shows that heart coherence produces alpha and gamma while it calms the anxiety bands of beta. When you practice mindfulness meditation for just 3 months, you start to grow your telomeres. If I offered you a pill that could increase your levels of circulating stem cells, lengthen your telomeres, dissipate beta amyloid plagues in your brain, improve your memory and attention levels, boost your serotonin, repair your DNA, regulate inflammation, boost your immune system, repair your skin, bone, cartilage, and muscle cells, power up your GH levels for cell repair, and enhance the neural connections in your brain, how much would you pay for it? Are you aware as to where you are? What are you doing about it? Are you taking your mind to a mind gym? How are you consciously balancing your left and right hemispheres? Which wave are you riding? And are you even riding a wave, or simply still being thrown left and right in the rough seas of high-range beta?